Welcome back for part two of the Mobile Forces version of Shiloh. Let's get straight out to the action. There was a few things that I forgot to mention on part one of this video. First, in order to get my two skirmishers up to 2 stars, because they were just short after river crossing, I ended up swapping out their officers, which really isn't that big of a deal for me because I end up buying a lot of officers when I'm building the army at Shiloh anyway for my Kaev and skirmishers, because the bigger those units are, the more of a efficiency hit they take. I was able to reuse those officers to create new units anyway. I do not recommend taking back any of the VPs during the Hornet's Nest phase, even though it would be easy to do so. It can just prolong how long that phase lasts before Pittsburgh Landing opens up. The other thing, as you probably noticed, is that using this mobile forces style causes action all over the field at once. So you're constantly pausing the game to assess what's going on in each area. It's not uncommon to be fighting in 4 or 5 different places on the screen at one time. I will say that captured enemy supply wagons make a good bait to force enemy movement. And overall, you'll find that using a lot of skirmishers in this battle reduces your overall casualties. With the mobile forces approach, I lost 13% of my forces. My actual total losses are less than the number of soldiers that I captured, so that's a pretty good deal. The AI lost nearly 67% of its forces. As you would expect, my two-star guns piled up a lot of kills. Even a few of the little small pounders with one star did a nice job. There's a crazy number of officer promotions with no reported losses, and the First Corps is now a major general. However, this is for, I'm pretty sure this only looks at the second day, because I had quite a few officers get wounded on day one. My First Corps officer is my only one to get a perk now, because the majority of my units were either new one stars or they had just gotten their second star, so nobody was close to moving up another level as it was. So that concludes this version of Shiloh. I'll be posting a day one victory version of Shiloh next, so you can be looking out for that. Thanks for watching.